What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to another day in my Corvette life. Today, I'm going to be talking about the race that happened this past weekend, the 12 Hours of Sebring. So this year, 2018, is Corvette Racing's 20th season of competition, and it's also their 20th time competing at Sebring. Out of those 20 years competing, they have won Sebring in class 11 times, and they've actually won the last 3 years in a row, 2015, 16, and 17. So this year, they would be going for 4 in a row. Corvette Racing driver Jan Magnussen makes his 19th consecutive start at the Sebring 12 Hours, tying none other than Johnny O'Connell at 19. So next year, if he's still around, it'll be 20. The team ended up qualifying 7th and 9th, which is not great, but again, Corvette Racing never qualify really well. They don't usually have the fastest car compared to everybody else, but the strategy and the experience usually makes them come out on top in the end. Race day came around and the 3 and 4 car were looking pretty strong. Up until about 30 minutes into the race, the number 3 car had some issues with the battery. They had to come in a few times, ended up being an alternator issue, ultimately put them many laps behind and pretty much out of contention. But they did end up running all the way to the end of the race, and they managed to scrap out a few points, which, who knows, at the end of the season, those couple of points may make a break. So with the number 3 car basically out of the race, it was all down to the number 4 car, and they ran it all the way to the end. They had a pretty much flawless race, and they were on the lead lap with everybody else right there at the end, but ultimately they ended up coming home in 6th place. It was a tough race this year, especially kind of out of the blue. BMW ended up being quick here at Sebring, and then obviously Porsche and Ford were fast as well. Ford still didn't have much of a change in balance of performance from Daytona, so they were definitely quick, but Porsche and BMW were also fast, and unfortunately, Corvette was kind of on their back foot as far as pace goes. They were close, but they were about half a second to a second off pace from the leaders. And when it comes to endurance racing, a half a second a lap, it adds up over time. And over 12 hours, you know, even though they were on the lead lap, they were really, they were struggling. They were trying to conserve enough fuel that they didn't have to make an extra stop. They were a little off strategy as well because just of the way that things worked out with cautions and everything. So they were able to short fill the car, but they weren't able to not come in for a final pit stop. So that put them in 6th place. So, unfortunately, that is that, and the streak ends at 3. So, the next round of the IMSA WeatherTech Sports Car Championship will be at Long Beach, and I will be there. So, I'm looking forward to that. Should be fun. I'll bring you guys some vlog content, you know. It'll be fun. And that's going to do it for today's video. I apologize for it being kind of a short video, but wasn't really a whole lot of talking points for this year's Sebring. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.